Your Highnesses, Your Excellencies, President Hamilton, Vice Chancellor Westerman, Mr. Berkeley, esteemed faculty, distinguished guests, and friends and families, Eid Mubarak, and thank you for gathering to celebrate the class of 2020's time at NYU Abu Dhabi. To my best friends turned family, to the class of 2020, this is your day and this is your speech. It hurts me beyond words that I can't have you here with me and that I can't look at you and laugh with you as I deliver it. It hurts me beyond words that Yankee Stadium isn't bursting in a glowing violet dismay. Earlier this year, when I used to imagine what this day could look like, I never thought I'd be standing in an almost empty room with a camera and a screen mediating this precious moment. Even though these circumstances have robbed us of many chances to be together this semester and cement our time at NYUAD, these past 3 years and a half were full of unbelievable growth and memories. So today, while we have a lot to yearn for, we also have a lot to be grateful for. In these turbulent times, we've had the incredible privilege of being guided by the leaders of this remarkable country and this remarkable institution. Here on Saadiyat, our NYUAD community has gone to great lengths to look after our physical and mental well-being and sustain our academic progress. So thank you to every office at NYUAD for your relentless service and care. To our professors who've shown us exemplary resilience, empathy, and mentorship, we would not be here today, nor be who we are today without you. And for that, we're forever indebted to you. Most importantly, thank you to our essential workers and to those on the front lines of this fight, from public safety to the dining hall staff, to Serco, to all the healthcare workers in the UAE. We cannot live without you and without the smiles you so gracefully wear underneath your masks. And of course, to my parents and my family, thank you for everything, and I love you. This year not only marks the celebration of the class of 2020's time at NYUAD, but also marks 10 years since the founding of this institution. Over the years, many of us have eagerly listened to President John Sexton's stories about the ambition and adventure of the past decade. So as we collect the fruits of this daring ambition today, I would like us to acknowledge that we're standing on the shoulders of giants, many of whom are strong women who have constructed an astonishing dream, a dream that we can now proudly call an undeniable reality. I myself stand on the shoulders of strong women as well, my mother and my late grandmothers. My grandparents were Palestinian refugees who were forced to leave their homes and families in search of safety and a better life, not just for my parents, but also for us. As a descendant of refugees, I've always struggled with the sense of home and belonging. Like many of you, I've spent hours and hours carefully crafting my hyphenated identity and dreading introductions where I'm asked, "Where are you from? Where do you call home?" Which is, of course, every other day at NYUAD. I understood very well that belonging is a privilege I may never have. But 4 years ago, with my admissions acceptance letter, came this NYUAD passport. Even though it physically spent the last 3 years in Marjoara because they refused to accept it at the airport, this passport quickly became a symbol of an alternative home I found at NYUAD. A home that lies in NYUAD's values of breaking barriers between people, disciplines, and ideas, despite operating in a world that tends to them. For my people, negotiating these barriers and resisting passivity was and still is an existential necessity. So in these unique circumstances, as we navigate new barriers and mobilities, we must recognize that this moment in our history did not create the inequalities we are witnessing, but rather simply amplified them. We must recognize that the struggle for social, economic, racial, and environmental justice did not start with this virus, and we must demand that it should not end after this virus. Today, I invite you to resist passivity and to act urgently and generously to stop the harm we're causing our hurting planet and to systemically confront the looming existential threat of this climate crisis. I invite you to honor NYUAD's mission of tackling borderless problems by building a united front in all of us that transcends countries and languages and hopes to leave the world a more equitable and sustainable place. Just like my grandparents fought for a better life for my siblings and I, despite not knowing us at the time, and just like this country and this institution fought for the betterment of our education, we must lead fights for those we do not know, those we do not look like, and against tragedies we have not ourselves experienced. Today, I'm confident that the class of 2020 will carry these passports in our hearts and will continue to lead these fights in solidarity from Shanghai in China to Abu Dhabi in the United Arab Emirates to New York City in the United States. Class of 2020, I'm jealous of all the graduate schools, companies, and NGOs of the world because they're about to receive a wonderful gift that is you. 300 funny, fascinating, unpredictable, and compassionate engineers, writers, scientists, poets, and of course, consultants. Class of 2020, it's been a pleasure. The Emirates Palace Candidate Weekend Dinner, the Bruno Mars in D2, the real ADs, the mock weddings, all the Abdul Wahhabs and all the cats, the conversations at the Palms and the Zoom calls, the birthday wishes at midnight, the bubble teas, and the many, many desert trips. It's all been an absolute pleasure. And with the distress and future, uncertain future, with the distress and fear uncertain future brings me, I find immense comfort in the thought of you affording me that pleasure again as we keep going and taking it all in together. I do not believe I can single-handedly summarize the footprint NYUAD has left on all of us. I believe my words will always fall short of encapsulating this transformative journey. But if I could borrow some great words to describe this place, I'd borrow them from Palestinian poet Mahmoud Darwish in his poem Passport, when he says, "Kullu qulubin nas jinsiyati," all of people's hearts are my nationality. So even if our NYUAD passport can't get us through the airport, I'm sure it will get us almost anywhere else. Thank you.